हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू फिजिक्स ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर क्लास 11 स्टूडेंट्स। लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 2 यूनिट्स एंड मेजरमेंट। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स। व्हाट आर सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स, व्हाट आर द रूल्स वी हैव टू फॉलो टू फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर, हाउ टू राउंड ऑफ द सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स इन एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन, वी स्टडीड इन डिटेल। So today I am going to start the new topic from the same chapter, that is dimensions of a physical quantity. Let us start the class. So first we have to know what is dimension. Dimensions of a physical quantity. In general, dimensions means length, breadth, height. So these all are what? Dimensions of a physical quantity. What do you mean by physical quantity? The quantity which can be expressed in terms of numerical values. The quantity, whenever we are going to express that quantity in terms of numbers, then that quantity we are going to call it as physical quantity. For example, time. Time we are going to express in terms of number. So this is a physical quantity. Velocity, 10 meter per second. Velocity is a physical quantity. Temperature, 100 degrees Celsius, 100, it is a number. So the quantity which can be expressed in terms of numerical values, they are called physical quantity. Now we are going to study about dimensions of a physical quantity. That means dimension, a measurable extent of a particular kind. That is length, breadth, depth, height, these all are what? Their dimensions. So then how to define dimensions of a physical quantity? See here, the dimensions of a physical quantity are the powers. These are the powers to which the fundamental units, we already studied about fundamental units, length, mass and time, these are the fundamental units. That must be raised to obtain the unit of that quantity. To obtain the unit of given any physical quantity, the fundamental units, just like length, mass and time, are raised. That means the powers of these fundamental units are raised. LMT, length means, we can write in short as L. Mass is M, time is T. L, M, T. So these powers, means the power of L, we are going to raise. For example, I can write 1, M raised to 2, T raised to 3 or minus 3 or plus 2. So I am going to raise the powers of these fundamental units to obtain unit of the given physical quantity. So this is dimensions of a physical quantity. So what are the dimensions of a physical quantity? These are the powers to which the fundamental units of mass, length and time, that must be raised to obtain the unit of that quantity. You can understand the concept only with the help of some example. Now you can observe some examples for dimensions of a physical quantity. The first example is about momentum. Momentum, which is also called as quantity of motion. Linear momentum, we can also call it as quantity of motion. Generally, linear momentum is denoted by P, and the equation for linear momentum is mass into velocity. Linear momentum, Newton's second law of motion. You already studied in the 9th standard. Again, you are going to study in PUC first year, laws of motion. So there you are going to study in detail about momentum. Now, we can concentrate only on its equation. So momentum is given by what? Mass into velocity. Here, momentum is equal to mass into velocity. Now we are going to find, or we are going to write its dimensions of physical quantity. Now I am going to write dimensions of this given physical quantity, that is momentum. dimensions of momentum we have to write. The equation is what? Mass into velocity. Mass keep as it is. Velocity can be written as, what is velocity? Velocity is rate of change of displacement. Displacement is denoted by S. Time is denoted by T. So this is what? V equal to S divided by T. Rate of change of displacement is called velocity. V equal to S by T. S indicates displacement. For example, from point A to point B, the object is moving. So the distance between this point A to B is called displacement. So instead of displacement, I can take it as length. Both are same here. So now let us write, in place of velocity, I can write length divided by time. Displacement divided by time. In place of displacement, I can write length. So now we got mass into length divided by time. So why we have to write in terms of length? Because here in dimensions of physical quantity, remember the three fundamental units, mass, length and time. These three terms we have to consider. So velocity can be written in terms of length and time. Mass into length divided by time. Now, these fundamental units, power should be raised. What are the powers of these three fundamental units? Mass, m raised to 1. M raised to 1 is equal to what? M. Length, L raised to 1. Time, time is in the denominator. So, we can write here. Mass is denoted by M. Length is denoted by L. Divided by time is denoted by T. M L divided by T. When T is taken to numerator, so we can write it as T raised to minus 1. So what is the final equation? M raised to 1, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 1. This is the dimension of momentum. So dimensions of momentum are 1 in mass, 1 in length and minus 1 in time. Is it clear? Then come to the second example. Here it is given physical quantity, force. Force is a physical quantity. So what is the equation for force? We know that F equal to M into A. M indicates mass, A indicates acceleration. Mass into acceleration, F equal to M into A. Mass keep as it is, this is a fundamental unit. Now, acceleration we have to write in terms of length and time. How to write? See here, what is acceleration? Acceleration is a rate of change of velocity. A equal to V divided by T, right? Then what is velocity? A rate of change of displacement, that is V equal to S divided by T. Is it clear? A equal to V by T, but V equal to S by T. In terms of acceleration, here I am going to write, in place of V, we can write S by T over T. That means S divided by T square. S is displacement. Displacement is equivalent to length. Length divided by time is denoted by T, T square. So here, mass keep as it is. In place of acceleration, I can write length divided by time square. Acceleration, we can write in terms of length and time like this. Now tell me how to raise the power of fundamental unit. So M, mass is denoted by M, length is denoted by L, time is denoted by T. Now write the equation M, L divided by T square. When T square is taken to numerator, so the final equation becomes M, L, T raised to minus 2 or M raised to 1. L raised to 1, T raised to minus 2. So now tell me dimensions of the force. Therefore, dimensions of the force are 1 in mass, 1 in length and minus 2 in time. Is it clear? Now we can solve one more example. So the given physical quantity is speed. What is speed? Speed is rate of change of distance. distance over time taken. Distance by time, that gives a speed. So distance by time is equal to distance and length, both are same here. So distance, in place of distance I can write length, length divided by time. There is no m value here. Then how to write the dimensions of the speed? So we got L divided by T, there is no M. So I can write the final equation as M raised to 0, because there is no mass here, M raised to 0. M raised to 0, L raised to 1, T when it is taken to numerator, it becomes T raised to minus 1. What is the dimensions now? M raised to 0, L raised to 1, T raised to minus 1. So these are the dimensions of the speed. What are the dimensions of the speed? 0 in mass, 1 in length, minus 1 in time. Then, fourth example, density. What is density? Density is mass per unit volume. What is density? Mass per unit volume. So, this volume I can write in terms of fundamental unit. Mass, length, time. Here we can use these three fundamental units. Now, volume is equal to what? Length into breadth into height. Length into breadth into height, that gives volume. Or I can write it as length, breadth is also equivalent to length, height is also equivalent to length. So I can write length into length into length gives length, L raised to cube. So here I can write mass divided by, in the place of volume, I can write length cube. Now tell me, what are the dimensions of the density? Here time is not given, T is 0. So I can write M raised to 1. Length when it is taken to numerator, it becomes L raised to minus 3. And time is not there here, so T equal to 0. The dimensions of the density are 1 in mass, minus 3 in length, 0 in time. Then, next example, area. What is area? Length into breadth. So, length keep as it is. Breadth, we can write in terms of fundamental unit. Breadth is also equivalent to length. So, I can write length into length gives length square. Then how to write the dimensions of the area? Here, mass and time are not there. So we can write M raised to 0, L raised to 2, T raised to 0. The dimensions of the area are 0 in mass, 2 in length, and 0 in time. Then next example, angular displacement. Angular displacement is given by length divided by radius. Length divided by radius, that gives angular displacement. Is it clear? Now, length divided by radius can be written as length keep as it is. Radius is also equivalent to length. So, length divided by length. Now, angular displacement, the equation it is given by length and length. Length divided by length will get cancelled. What is the answer? 1. So, what are the dimensions of the angular displacement? So, this is dimensionless. Angular displacement. This is not having any dimension. This is a dimensionless, because M is 0, L is 0, T is also 0. That's why this is a dimensionless physical quantity. Is it clear? So, dimensions of the angular displacement are 0 in mass, 0 in length, 0 in time. Or simply you can write, this is a dimensionless physical quantity. Is it clear? So, now I will give you some physical quantity as a homework. You can try to solve yourself. First example, I can give you volume. Second example, work. Third example, power. Fourth example, pressure. Then fifth example, impulse. Then sixth example, frequency. Seventh example, kinetic energy. Eighth example, surface tension. Ninth example, potential energy. And the last example, angle. I will give you their equations. You just find their dimension. Volume, length into breadth into height. Work, work is given by force into displacement. Force into displacement. Then power. Power is rate of doing work, that is work divided by time. Pressure. What is pressure? Force per unit area. Right? Then impulse. Impulse is the large amount of force in a short interval of time. That is force into time. Frequency. Number of oscillations per cycle. Per second, that is 1 by time. Then kinetic energy. Kinetic energy Ke is equal to half mv square. This is mass and this is velocity. Surface tension. Surface tension is force divided by length. Potential energy is potential energy P equal to mgh. Then angle, this is arc length divided by radius. I had given 10 examples and also I had given their related equation. Using these equations, try to find what are the dimensions of these given physical quantity. So let us take it as assignment. Try to solve yourself all the 10 examples and I will give you the proper dimensions of all these 10 examples in the next session. You can note down all these 10 examples and you can solve in any rough paper. Then you can check your right dimensions in the next session. Thank you.